Yes, good morning, my dear students. We were doing chapter A Short Monsoon Diary. So we will be continuing from the back exercise that we were discussing yesterday. So let's continue with the same one. Here we have discussed questions up to 7. So you all are supposed to do all these 7 questions in your FAIR notebook. Okay, at any of the time I can ask you to send me your FAIR notebooks. So without any delay, you have to submit to me your notebooks according to the given schedule, which I will be sharing with you. Okay, so now let's do that. Here are some words that are associated with the monsoon, and as many words as you can do this list. Can you find words from these in your language? It means in Hindi or Punjabi, you have to tell me the meaning of these words. Can you tell me the meaning of downpour, floods, mist, cloudy, parkers, cold, umbrella? Okay, we start from backward. What do we say umbrella in Hindi or Punjabi? You can type in chat box. This is a one word answer. Yes, you type in chat box. What will be the Hindi of umbrella? That is so simple. Yes, in Hindi, chhatan, in Punjabi, what do we say? Meaning of, yes, chhatri. In chhatri, that is a Punjabi word, and chhata, that is a Hindi word. Okay, cold. What will be the Hindi of cold? Yes, type in chat box. Okay, good. Sardi, yes. And what about other students? Only 2-3 students are participating. Hurry up, type your answers in chat box. I'm reading your names also, those who are participating. Thund, okay, very good. Very nice. Okay, Parkers. 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 Okay, the question that, see, these are some words already given and you all might know the meanings of, but you just add up some words and tell me Hindi also. Add up some words that are related, that are associated with the monsoon. Okay. Bijli katoti. Lavish is very enthusiastic to give me good answers. Very good. Okay. Bijli katoti. Okay. Now find out some words which are associated with this. Which are associated with, you can say, rain. What can be those words? Alternative like that. Alternative words. See, in Hindi or Punjabi we say that dhund bahut hai, dhund, fog, dhund. That word can be added. Okay. Sirene, you can say silence, shant. Okay. Raincoat can be associated with this. Now tell me other words which can be associated with this given list. Tell me other words which can be associated with this given list. Hailstorm, very good. Fog, raincoats, dampness, good. Rain shoes is not a word, Lavish. I have never listened rain shoes word. So, bachche, think about maximum words. Rain boots, yes. Gum boots, yes. Thunder. So, there are so many words and you can write down in Hindi or in Punjabi. Okay. Now, let's move to next question. You just look at these sentences. Biju wandered into the garden in the evening. The trees were ringing with bird song. Now, these highlighted words, wandered, was ringing, chirp. Wandered tells that Biju, what did he to that evening. But was ringing tells us what was happening continuously. It means when past tense is given, it is telling what action took place. But when past continuous is given, it means what action was going on in past. Okay. Now you look at these sentences. It is also telling that what happened in the past, they are also telling that which was going continuously. Okay. So, bachche, for this, look at the blackboard. See, when verb second form is given, it will tell what happened basically. Okay. And when we have given verb first form plus ing, it means what was going on. Going on continuously. What was going on continuously? Okay. So now I'm going to share screen with you. You tell me what verb should be written here. We get out of the school bus, the bell ring, and everyone dash to the class. What should be the correct answer for that? What? Put the verbs in the bracket into their proper forms. The first one is done for you. We got out of the school bus. It happened in past. The bell was ringing. This action was going continuously. And everyone was rushing to class. This action was also going continuously. Okay. We got out of the school bus. The bell was ringing. And everyone was rushing to class. Clear, bachche? Now tell me second, type in chat box. Don't raise your hand, type in chat box. First answer. Second, sorry. The traffic. What should be the correct answer of here? Stop. What should be the correct answer of stop? Think about all these answers. And I'm going to read your messages. I'm going to read in chat box. How many of you are participating? I'm going to read your chat box. Yes. You write down only bachche answer. There is no need to write down full sentence. The traffic stop. So in place of stop, what should come? The traffic. Yes, very good. Stop. So many students are writing correct answer. Good. The traffic stopped. Some people sit. In place of sit, what should be coming? Some people were sitting. Yes, some people were sitting on the road and they tell me it should be past tense or it should be past continuous. Hurry up. Diya, Janvi, very good. Your answers are absolutely fine. They are always active in my class. Pari Gupta, Jasmine Kaur, very nice student. Shabd, Lavish, Diya, very nice. Good. Sanvi, very good. These students are active students of my class. I really want to appreciate them. So these 10, near about 9 to 10 students have sent me answer and their all answers are absolutely correct. So I have typed here answer. The traffic stopped. Some people were sitting on the road and they were shouting. It means sitting and shouting. This action was going continuously there, but traffic stopped. It happened only once there. Okay. I wear my raincoat. It rains and people get wet. So what should be there in place of wear? Hurry up. Kavish, Janvi, Pari, very good. Yes. Arshpreet, Sanvi, very nice. Jasmine. Bachche, you can write down only one word. It will save your time. Yes, Simarpreet or Anya, Jasmine, very nice. So here, what should be there? I wore my raincoat. It. Yes, tell
Good morning,
me.
ma'am.
Yes.
मैम वो मैम मैं वीडियो ऑन नहीं कर सकता यहाँ पे ना मतलब बस लाइट गई हुई है तो फिर अंधेरा है पूरा तो इसलिए वीडियो ऑफ कर सकते हैं
नो प्रॉब्लम यू टाइप योर आंसर्स ओनली इन चैट बॉक्स आई वांट टू सी योर आंसर्स आई वांट टू सी योर पार्टिसिपेशन ओके सो इट वाज रेनिंग क्लियर एंड पीपल वर गेटिंग Yes, people were getting. She dash a film. She only 5-6 students. Same students are participating. She tell me. Hurry up. Type your answers. Very good. She saw a film. Yes. She saw a film. She saw a film and she was narrating. Yes, good, good. Suruchi, Sanvi, very nice. Jasmine, continuously they are participating and sending me answers. Madhav, Rudransh, good. Very good. So it seems that these students are attentive. What about others? What about others? Why are they not typing their answers in chat box? I'm announcing your name also, those who are participating in my class. I think the participants who are writing the answers, they are active. Others are still in their bed, having rest. She was narrating to her friends friends, plural is there, who were listening. Who were listening carefully. Clear? We dashed to the exhibition. We went to the exhibition. Some people were buying. Some people were buying clothes while other were playing games. Good. Nice. Shabd and Lavish, they are also participating. Good. Were playing. Okay. Now move to next question. The class dash quiet. The class was quiet. Yes. Suruchi, Lavish, Janvi, Sanvi, Tanmay, Taranya, Shabd, Jasmine. All are sending me correct answer in chat box. Good. The class was quiet. Some children were reading books and the rest were drawing. Yes. So, bachche, you can check your answers from the given list. You all are sending me correct answer. It means this tense is clear to you. Okay. So now I'm going to move to next question. Next question we have, here are some of the words from your lesson which are used for describing different kinds of sounds like drum, swish, tinkle, caw, drip. All these words are describing different kinds of sounds. Okay, so you have to match these words with their correct meaning. To fall in small drops. Hurry up. Type in chat box. Kavish is the first one. Janvi is the second one. Pari, Arish, Jasmine, third one. They all are sending correct answer. What about others? Bachche, come out of your comfort zone. If you type your answer, you will become confident that your answer is correct. You will feel happy when I will be announcing your name because I am taking the names of only those children who are participating. Now I'm going to announce those names who are not participating. Let me take their names, those who are sitting like a passive listener in my class. I don't want to see passive listener. You should be active in my class. My chat box should be full and I'm going to read your names, those who are writing their answer. So its answer is drip. Yes. Good. To fall in small drops, drip. To make a sound by hitting a surface repeatedly. What is that? To make a sound by hitting a surface repeatedly, it is drum. Yes. Drum. To move quickly through the air, making a soft sound. To move quickly through the air. What is that? Very nice. There are so many students who have sent me correct answer. I'm really happy with their performance. Nandini, Shabd, Anant, Matangi. Very nice, bachche. Very nice. Keep on participating. It is good for you. Harman, Anjali, Taranya. Very good. Prabh Sharanjot. Good, good. Harsh sound made by birds. Harsh sound made by birds. What is that called? It is called caw. Yes, good. Ringing sound of a bell or breaking glass. Ringing sound. What is this called? It is called tinkle. Yes. Whatever the messages you are typing, only I can read your messages, not all students. Because I have changed the option, the messages will be read by me. So Madhav, Rudransh, Harman, all are sending me correct answer and they all are active participants now. Very good. Rudransh and Madhav, they are participating. Good. Lavish, Sanvi. No, bachche, hard sound made by birds is caw. Lavish, check your answer. Fifth is a tinkle. Ringing sound is a tinkle. Okay. Now, fill in the blanks using a correct form of the word. You have to use the same word, but you have to, at the same time, you have to use correct word. So what will be that? Tell me. Ramesh dash on his desk in impatience. Very good. Abundance of students. Very good. It is drummed. It is drummed. Ramesh drummed. Next, rainwater dashed from the umbrella all over the carpet. Rainwater dripped. The pony dashed its tail. The pony, basically it is a, what is that? What is pony? Here, what is the meaning of pony? Yes. Young one of which animal? Horse, okay. So the pony dashed its tail. So what will be its answer? It was swishing. Swishing its tail. Yes, the pony was swishing its tail. Clear? Now let's move to next part. The dash of breaking glass woke me up. The dash of breaking glass. The tinkle of. The dash of the raven disturbed the child's sleep. Raven is also a bird. So it's harsh sound. For harsh sound, we will be using caw. Clear? Clear, bachche? And sure enough, I received a check in the mail. Complete each sentence below by using appropriate phrase from the ones given below. So I'm giving you 2-3 minutes for this. You think over this and then type your answer. Think over all these answers. Do it in class only. And then you send me answers. Clear, bachche? So what should be the first answer? I saw thick black clouds in the sky and dash it soon started raining heavily. And yes, so first is sure enough. Okay, now tell me what will be the second answer. The blue umbrella was dash. The blue umbrella was, hurry up. Only 9-10 students have sent me answer in chat box. What about others? Anjani, your answer is right. Matangi, Sanvi, Simarpreet, Pari. Only these answers are correct. Suruchi, others are sending me wrong. Samiksha, Rajat, Jasmine. No, bachche, others' answers are wrong. Only the names I have announced, these students have sent me correct answer. Prabhasharan, Arshpreet, very good. Diya, good. So its answer is big enough. The blue umbrella was big enough. Clear? The butterflies are, the butterflies are, tell me its answer. The butterflies are colorful enough. Colorful enough. The lady was, the lady was, the lady was, yes, brave enough. The lady was brave enough. Good. All have sent me correct answer. I'm really happy with this performance of some of the students. I have taken screenshot of also the active participants of my class. This chat box will be saved in my mobile, sorry, in my laptop. I'm going to save this chat box because all the chat, because it will be very easy for me to make a list of all the active participants. I'm going to save it because it's very easy to save this chat of today. And afterwards, I'm going to make a list. I will make a list that how many times these students have participated. And it will be very easy for me to find out non-participant students who are only passive listener, who are not participating at all. And I don't know that they are doing anything in class or not. I have to talk to their parents also. That this discussion was going on and some students, those who have not participated, your ward names is in that list. That it will be a good option for you. Tell me. Those who are not participating. Shall I announce the names of those students? Okay, now next question. The boy was dashed to call out to his sister. The boy was... No, some students are sending me wrong answer. Think over this. Yes, now your answer is right. It is anxious enough. The boy was anxious enough. Good. The man was dashed to offer help. The man was kind
enough. The man was kind enough. The victim's injury was bad for him. The victim's injury was The victim's injury was injury can be what? Yes, it can be injury can be serious enough. The victim's injury was serious enough. That person was dared to repeat the same mistake again. The person was foolish. The person was foolish enough. He told me he was sorry and he would compensate for the loss. I said only one is left. That would be, yes, tell me, fair enough. Clear? So, bachche, you can check your answer. Do this back exercise very, very carefully, because in your exam preparation, you will not find any kind of difficulty when you have to revise it thoroughly, because such kind of back exercise can be asked in your paper. Okay. Okay. Now we are going to do speaking part. So in this also, I want active participation from 8th B. Okay. Do you believe in superstitions? Why or why not? Working with your partner, write down three superstitious beliefs that you are familiar with. Now you are not supposed to write down, you are only supposed to speak. So raise your hand. Do you believe in superstitions? Because in this chapter, what is given? Chuchundar. Chuchundar superstition is given that we should have chuchundar, only then we will have a wealth. It is a auspicious thing. So do you believe, yes or not? If yes, tell me the reason. If not, tell me the reason. Okay. And you think about three superstitious beliefs that you know about. You are familiar with this. So who is going to tell me? Hurry up. I want active participation. Okay. Arshpreet, you tell me.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, beta.
I didn't believe in superstition, but my family believe.
Okay, what kind of
superstition? One superstition that not to eat non-veg on Tuesday.
Okay, you should not have non-veg on Tuesday. Okay. Your family believes, but you don't. Ma'am. You take non-veg on Tuesday?
Ma'am, no.
Because your family is following this thing.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Good answer. Very good. Okay, Lavish, what do you want to say?
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Ma'am, truly I speak that I don't believe in superstitions, because there's no reason behind the superstitious beliefs, or it is all rumors, or ma'am, rumors. Yeah. These are all rumors about superstition beliefs.
And another child, Janvi, you tell me, what do you think? Yes, Janvi, what do you say about this answer?
I don't believe in superstitions. These are just blind beliefs. The ignorant and conservative people believe them and observe these superstitions. The common superstition that I have faced in my families is that don't start a new project on Saturday, don't wash clothes on Tuesday, stop if a black cat crosses your path.
Good. Nice. Okay, now
Harman. Ma'am, I'm going to say something.
Wait, Harman Pal, you tell me. After that, I'll
Good morning, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I don't believe in superstitions, as these are just myths, and I think that these are not true. But my family believes, as if we keep footwear upside down, then my mother says that it leads to family feuds, like fights and all that. And one more, that we should not clean any anything in the evening, like mop the floor, etc.
Yes, it happens in every house. Our parents were following and we are also following it. Okay, yes, Lavish.
Yes, ma'am.
My parents believe on superstitious belief, like no haircuts on Tuesday. 13 is the anonymous number, or we can say like no washing clothes on Thursday, no hair wash on Thursday.
Okay.
And that's all.
And Madhav, what do you want to say?
Yes, ma'am. I don't believe in superstitious, ma'am, because of. Don't start a new project on Saturday. Stop if a black cat crosses your path.
Yes, good. So today Rudransh was speaking or Madhav? Who was speaking?
Ma'am, Madhav.
Madhav, good. So very good. Bachche, now time is running out. You responded so well. I was happy with the performance of 8B today because I have made a list of so many students, those who were actively participating in my class. I really want to appreciate all those students. It's really good because in this way, your English preparation will be done in class and you will be enjoying your class also. So that's good. So we are not able to complete this chapter. We are only on the speaking part. Writing part will be done tomorrow. So tomorrow we will be able to do this chapter. Okay, so bachcha, take care of yourself. You complete your pending work, whatever the questions. See, now annotation has started. So you clear? I'm going to clear. Okay, so bachcha, whatever the work we have done today, okay, you revise it thoroughly. If you face any kind of difficulty, if any of the topic is not complete, you can ask me tomorrow. Okay, bachcha.